Well, as President Hockfield mentioned, there are lots of different sorts of intelligence. There's, we've talked a lot about intelligence in the human brain. Of course, people have been trying to make computers be intelligent in some way. I'm interested when we get people and computers working together at scale. People are good at one sorts of things. Machines can drive trains. They're good at other things. Of course, sometimes we try to get them working together. And when we put them together, then typically we get somebody using a computer to help them do their taxes or something. It's not very stunning. And we only have one of them. I'm interested when we get people and computers working together at what I'll call web scale. What's web scale? Well, the scale of things on the web. There are around a trillion web pages out there. There are billions of people. So when you look at the web, actually, we haven't studied it enough, and we don't really know much about it. We can imagine, as this artist did, what it will look like. We can take some data about the web and try and plot it in two or three dimensions. That doesn't really tell us a lot, although we should be doing more of this web science. But this is a huge scale at which I'd like people to be working together and working together with machines. So it's not just our intelligence, but machine intelligence. We're not doing it yet. What we are doing, though, is to a certain extent getting people to work together at scale. And what do they do when you connect them on the web? Well, they join Facebook and Twitter, and they make things like Wikipedia. This isn't totally people working in a very, very web-like way, because they still have the problems of the boundaries between different social networking silos which they climb between. But they are working together at quite large scale, only as people, though. This is people working together, but they're not using the computer as intelligence. The computer is helping them. It's being the instrument by which they communicate. It's running the web browser, but it's not using its intelligence. So conversely, what happens if we get lots of computers and we connect them? Well, basically nothing, until you program them, and then we program them, and they do things like search for extraterrestrial intelligence. They try to work out the weather forecast and things like that. And when they do that, they do, in fact, work at large scale. And when we put linked open data out there, that's very exciting and important to do. But they're not using people. They're not also using people. So what would it be like if we actually tried to get the mass of humanity and the mass of the machines to be working together, connected by the internet? Connected. It's all about connections, isn't it? What's important, most of intelligence is all about connections. It's about finding connections. Suppose that we had a system out there on the web. We had connections shared between people and machines. Suppose when I put somebody in my Facebook group, when I said that somebody was in that photo, that was connected with the way machines work. Suppose a half-formed idea in my head and a half-formed idea in yours could both be somehow put onto the web and connected. It's all about connections. This is technology we're calling the semantic web technology, and it involves representing technology, representing the connections on the web just by links. It's just like the web, very much. Very simple technology. It's technology in which we use URIs, but it's where we involve the computers connecting in and processing the same information as the people are connecting, and therefore making themselves part of a new system. To make it happen, we need to take those old programs, which aren't web scale, and webize them, make them work at web scale. So we can take these, where we've approximated to this, where we've got people working at web scale, but not with people, with machines involved, then we involve the machines by adding some meaning the machines can figure. We call that semantics. We expose the web of data in the social networking systems. These are all things that we're doing at MIT to try and get towards this central situation where we've got everybody working together at scale. When we have machines working together, but people are not involved, we try to add into those machine systems an understanding of the social aspects that you need to be able to work with people, an understanding of accountability, appropriate use of information, privacy. We might try to make machines aware of those social aspects. We call it policy awareness. So all those ways are ways in which we're doing research to take the exciting place that we are now and to take it to something where we think it's going to be much more exciting when we produce an infrastructure where machines are contributing their intelligence and people are contributing their intelligence as part of one great big infrastructure, which will be a huge infrastructure for innovation in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, David. Just, I appreciate your standing up for a second to absorb the question.